we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today trying to push their team to victory. It's Wilson's Seahawks going up against Rodgers' Packers. The frozen tundra is going to be in full effect here today as we send you up to a snowy Wisconsin. On the call, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, there's just something that feels right about a snowy day for football in Wisconsin, and that's what we have here on the frozen tundra of Lambeau Field in Green Bay. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Seattle Seahawks and the Green Bay Packers. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we look at this Packer team as we enter play here. They come in playing pretty good football, winners of four of their last six games. Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Seahawks, they come in off. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. On first down. And this is caught. It's Jimmy Graham. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And good to see Jimmy back out there moving okay after the ruptured patella in week 12 last year. You've dealt with that injury, haven't you?
I have, and let me tell you know that expression, I feel your pain? I felt Jimmy's when it happened. Now, mine didn't happen quite the same way his did. His happened in the line of duty. He was playing in a game. For me.
And oh, right away, he lost the football. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. And without a doubt, not the way they pictured that opening drive unfolding.
No, they were making progress. They weren't exactly in high gear, but they were making a few yards along the way. And now.
The 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
It's a gain of four there, and it gives them a new set of downs.
I don't care how many times you tell the story, it never loses its luster for me. Doug Baldwin, undrafted, out of Stanford, and plays like a number one receiver should in the NFL. I don't care how you cover him. I don't care that his size isn't great. He's the one that typically comes up with the football.
Absolutely. His roots go all the way back to Gulf Breeze, Florida, where he's from, right on the water near Pensacola, and then, of course, to Stanford, and boy, he's been good. Second down here after the incomplete pass. Second and 10 now, Wilson. Baldwin with it over the middle. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did. When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
One of the selling points of the in route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success as they did on that play.
And nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender his caliber let it get away, but it does get away at second down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Throwing over the middle, it's incomplete. Here comes the eighth play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. On third down, Wilson. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And Hauschka's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive only yields 3 points.
Yeah, they were able to move the football, but the defense stiffened once their backs were to the end zone, and they were able to hold them.
The offense set to take the field here as they have the football in the final minute of this first quarter. They'll throw on first down with Wilson. And Graham's got it over the middle. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So one quarter in the books on a cold December afternoon. 7-3 the score. We're back to Lambeau in just a moment.
NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Head & Shoulders. Shoulders were made for greatness, not dandruff.
Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here. On first down, Wilson. It's complete to Lockett. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
We got three, fellas.
On second down, Wilson. And he finds his tight end, Graham. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little.
And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And all the way in, touchdown, Seattle. Doug Baldwin with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Seahawks are able to strike for 6. Well, you know he can be explosive, and he's ultra-explosive there on the fly route.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches and we've had quoted back to us, well, you know something? When you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's coming or not. Well, sometimes...
drop you into the start of this next possession. The score, 7-0. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for 6.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out. There are a good number of coaches that anytime they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver. And on that play, it was batted down.
Jimmy Graham, the intended receiver. And now it's third down. He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long with all the targets trying to go after him, he's obviously gotten smart and his pride has kicked in. Made a terrific play.
From the gun on third down, Wilson. He hits Jermaine Kearse. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just short for fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. They'll indeed go for it with Wilson. And this is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Packers are going to get the football. Start of this next possession, the score 7-0. Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. A good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened.
You think
there.
That factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end. One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
And he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively. But instead, it just brings up fourth down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground. Oh, the spin. It's a 47-yard punt, but they did give up 10 on the return. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. So now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. Throwing is Wilson, and a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Here's Wilson. Caught left side, Williams. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
Floats one there, incomplete.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs. offense gets set to take over. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. He sets to fire deep. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. That late in the... So now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. Here comes the Seahawks offensive unit. They'll have it first to begin the third. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half? Because that's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker board?
Yeah, those two.
Baldwin with it over the middle. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. So an excellent throw and an excellent catch there.
Zone coverage, which means you just have to find the open areas in between defenders, is exactly what happened on that play.
They'll throw on first down with Wilson. Man open left side, it's Williams. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and nine.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Again, Wilson. And Graham's got it over the middle. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. And he is enjoying another fine performance just like a week ago. I mean, let's be honest, when he's playing like this, it creates a lot of matchup nightmares.
And it really does, because it creates a ton of headaches. You tried to design so many coverage for a guy like this, but truthfully, he should have an answer to anything that's thrown at him. If you throw a linebacker at him, he should have speed and agility on his side. If you throw a defensive back against him, he should have size on his side. So no matter what you throw at him, he should have the final answer. And in his last two games,
yes.
Oh boy, has he ever.
Now it's Wilson. It's caught. Lockett. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It'll be a gain of 16 for number 16. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
A gain of 6 there on first.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Wilson will throw again. His pass caught at the 4. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Throwing again here, Wilson. That's caught at the 2. Call it a 3-yard gain, and it'll be second and goal. That time they hit him out of the slot on the drag.
And that route takes some fortitude from the guy running it, because he knows he's going through the briar patch, as I like to call it, right? He's trying to work his way through all that traffic, and people wanted to put a little contact on it. Really well done.
And that one incomplete as it breaks a string of 8 straight pass completions.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
On 3rd and goal, Wilson. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Jermaine Kearse with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Seahawks have taken the lead.
All drives that result in points hurt a defense, But when they are the sustained variety, play after play, and they just can't get off the field and stop them, that can be demoralizing.
Drop you into the start of this next possession. The score, 7-0. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in the touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. Now Wilson on first down. And that will be caught, but out of bounds. Out of bounds, ruled incomplete here.
I don't know about you, but I wanted to reach out of the booth and snatch that pass myself. That thing floated forever up there. I think that threw off the timing of the receiver. That's why he couldn't get his feet down even though he caught the ball.
You know, Charles, I would have liked to have seen that.
Yeah, me too.
For you, I wanted to see you reach out and catch that.
Yeah, you've heard about my hands, huh?
And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. On third down, Wilson. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped. Altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it. And now fourth down. Here's John Ryan now as he's on to punt for Seattle.
But, partner, anytime someone tells me that fundamentals are leaving the game.
And how about this, a fake? Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. It's a big play that time on the fake punt. And on fourth and long, somehow they're able to keep the drive going. In the slot on the right is Graham.
Always enjoy a good fake, but I really enjoy it when he throws the football from pump formation. Now, you were a kicker and a punter in high school. Did you ever do that?
One time, threw to my man Tim Jones on a botched field goal attempt. Hit him right in the numbers, and Jonesy just dropped it.
Oh, the poor guy. Well, we had a fake punt here, and this guy caught it, so I think he and his friends will be okay with that one.
And he loves his play call, right? He's been waiting for this one all week long.
Been had that arm loosened up ever since they got to the stadium.
This will be caught at about the 6. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It'll be a gain of 8 yards. And that's going to make it third down and less than a yard. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Wilson now to throw on third down. And able to find Graham, complete. Just a gain of a yard, but it's going to set him up with a first and goal. And now, partner, he has surpassed Marvin Harrison's record for most catches in a single season. He's got 144.
It's amazing. He almost did it quietly because Marvin Harrison wasn't a guy that we saw much in the media, but boy, did he produce. Now he steps aside. Marvin Harrison is number 2. We were here today to see the new number 1.
Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make play.
And we drop you into the start of this next possession. The score, 7-0. And out now come the Seahawks. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Second and 10 now, Wilson. It's caught on the right side, Williams. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. And now this is back-to-back weeks that he has treated us with a really solid performance.
We know he's great. We expect it. But this is pretty special what we're watching here. We're watching a guy in total command of every situation, throwing the ball well, guiding his team, moving them. This is a whole lot of fun to watch.
Yeah, it was fun last week. Sometimes it feels like we're at all these games.
And the offense lining up first and 10. Well, throw on first down with Wilson. And Graham's got it over the middle. And he's able. And now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. So they're operating in the red zone. Wilson wants to throw it. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. Doug Baldwin, his second touchdown of the game and his ninth on the year. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about...
So this offense will head back out there, already in excellent field position thanks to the interception. As Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They take over with great field position. They've got the big lead. Most would say they should kneel it, but the key word there is should. You never know here.
You never know. That's the exact play that should happen. But some people like stats. You know, some people like to put more things up on the board. But kneel down is usually the right play here.
We'll see what they do in this situation. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Tyler Lockett was the target there, and that'll bring up second down.
Not only did they drop what looked like an interception in the end zone, they blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Second and 10. It's Wilson again. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Jermaine Kearns with his second touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season. And the Seahawks capitalize on the short field as they take it in for 6.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning.
And we drop you into the start of this next possession. The score, 7-0. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one deal here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel-down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now, to put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there.
Here's Wilson. And that one is incomplete. He just dropped it. But they're up big on the scoreboard, so maybe he can chuckle about later.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And, yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. He's got Kearns. And taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Rawls, the lone man in the backfield. Now Wilson. That's caught at the 2. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
And now we've hit that stage of the game, partner, where one of our predecessors, one of the great commentators of all time, he's to sing in this situation when this game appeared to be over.
I know the fat lady's been singing for some time.
No, not her at all. This
but
is one of our guys.
She's singing too.
Well, partner, there's something special about a game in the snow. Just always fun in these elements, although a little chillier up here in the open-air booth. The only thing that's not fun is that we got the mid-game notification that our flight was canceled tonight, but we'll deal with that later. It was really a fun game to watch, though.
It was, and there is something special about games played in the snow because the element of surprise really kicks in. You don't know how they're going to handle the ball, if someone's going to make a dramatic play just out of nowhere, and all of a sudden it just changes the course of things. But a big shout-out to our crew to make sure that we were comfortable up here, as comfortable as one could be. In these elements, they took care of us and made sure we were dressed properly.
So for the Seahawks, the win pushes their record now to 11-2 on the year, and they'll return home next week to take on the LA Rams. Meanwhile, for the Packers, they can ill afford to drop too many more as they fall to 7-6 on the year, and they'll try and turn things around next week as they have a date at Soldier Field with the Chicago Bears. So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew.